What is going on, YouTubeverse? John Stanek from Johnny Radio here with a dear friend of mine on this very special episode, the top five John Williams scores of all time, and just in time for the documentary that's coming out on Disney Plus about John Williams, which also hits today. But my dear friend Nathaniel Ahart is here. You may know him from the many episodes and many countdowns that we've done. And I thought, what better person to do a joint top five for an episode such as this? I mean, he has so much music knowledge, but also so much film knowledge. And I know we'll probably have maybe a little bit of overlap here, but there's so many scores to choose from in this man's just total history. Amazing. But welcome to this episode, sir. This is going to be fun.
And thank you for having me on once again. It's been a minute, but always a pleasure to be back on Johnny Radio. Now, I will say this definitely, I had to sit with it for only like 15 minutes. And then I was like, okay, I think I know what I'm going to do. Nice. Because all these choices, I don't think will necessarily surprise anybody. But the rankings of these choices might surprise you a little bit.
Yeah. And so basically how we're going to do this is we'll go back and forth on each of our choices from five to one. And then at the end, we'll do like a combined top five based on, you know, which ones were highest and so forth. But, and then of course we'll as always have a couple honorable mentions to talk about for sure on this. So, since you're the guest of honor, man, you want to start us off with your number five?
Sure. And I'll say before I get into it, now these, you know, scores that I have ranked here, it's not necessarily based on the ranking of the soundtrack albums, because that can be very different with the way that the tracks are, you know, sequenced and what have you. The reason I picked these scores in the order that I did was because I think the best themes, the best moments from these scores that stand out to me the most. And so that's why some of these are
the
like a bit
thing.
Higher.
Yeah.
Okay, good. So we're probably on a similar page here.
Yeah.
But I would have to start off by saying my number five is... Jaws.
Nice.
I mean,
nice.
Come on.
Yeah.
I mean, just that
yeah.
small motif and what he, you know, John Williams builds out of it in his first Oscar for best original score, in his first big collaboration with Steven Spielberg. I mean, this is one of the most iconic scores of all time, and it's only number five on my list. But I think, yet again, there's so many musical cues from this movie that have just been, you know, referenced in pop culture over and over again, especially the one of the dolly zoom, you know, like you could go on and on about how great this score is and just how much he gets out of, you know, just the simplicity of a few notes and how that can, you know, really build to some quite terrifying results. And yeah, there isn't really a whole lot to say. It's Jaws. I'm sure you've seen it. It's great, especially the ending suite in the barrel chase. My goodness, you can't beat it, man. It's just absolutely phenomenal.
Yeah, as a matter of fact, you know, when I think about Jaws, you know, of course, the first thing that comes to mind is those first two notes, which is just brilliant. Like the, like you said, the simplicity of it. And I think when he told Spielberg or showed it to him initially, he was like, what is this? Like, what am I supposed to do with this?
Yeah.
But then he realized, oh, man, how genius it is. But yeah, like the adventurous part of like when they're out at sea, like all those different elements to it, you know, like this, it's not just the horror score throughout the whole that, that most people think about. You have these really uplifting moments as well. And yeah, it's not like one that I go back and like listen to as a soundtrack a lot, but just for, you know, how iconic it is and what it did. I mean, the very first blockbuster of all time. I mean, all that. Yeah, I have this on my list as well, but a little higher. So my number five is... Superman, 1978.
That was my
number,
around number six. Yeah.
Okay.
I came so close.
I actually like, In truth, like there's another soundtrack that I love more, but I had to get this in there just to, for inclusivity, like because and this is like you know he had already done Star Wars at this point, so you knew he could make these just amazing heroic themes. But I mean, just hearing the Superman theme, da, 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 which now I always think about Seinfeld, the Clips episode when they're like Jerry's running and stuff. But I mean, that is brilliant enough. But then, I mean, the Krypton theme as well, the build of that, like that drone, and then the da, 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 it's just like, and you get that image of like, you know, flying over Krypton and stuff. You know, Richard Donner, I think, really did some great work on that film. I think he's an underrated director, but yeah, what a theme, man. I had to include it.
Oh yeah, dude, I can't blame you for a second, man. The only reason I didn't put Superman in my top five is actually this does have to do with the soundtrack because this is one of my favorite John Williams like albums, you know what I mean? But I think there's certain parts of it that are just a little bit boring. Maybe that's about it. But honestly, dude, even talk about like the Can You Read My Mind? See, it's just one of the most stunning pieces of work John Williams has ever done. I mean, you could
Beautiful.
go on and on about how great the score is. And I just watched the documentary on Christopher Reeve, and just I have to give a shout out to him because his commitment to this role, like he took this movie seriously when a lot of other people thought it was a joke. And I think, you know, with between him and Donner and Williams, which I mean, it's like the perfect man. I think that's why this movie has stood the test of time, is being not only the first great superhero movie, but still one of the best that we've seen in the genre.
Yeah, and without the theme, I don't think it would have been nearly as good. I mean, I'm
Yeah,
sure
one of the
someone
most
else would have
iconic.
come up with something, but I mean, Williams is just the best to ever do it, man. I think we can agree on that.
Oh,
So,
yeah, 100%.
yeah, man. So what's your number four?
So my number four is The Empire Strikes Back. Now, I will say between this and my number three, I was really flip-flopping, but I had to really, you know, sit back and think because on any other day, this could be number three. I don't know, but I think that even though, you know, we have the first Star Wars movie, the themes for the most part already been set, but my goodness, I mean, this is one of the most iconic scores of all time. I mean, whether it be the Imperial March,
Da, 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 da,
that,
da.
or
Yeah.
the Yoda's theme,
Yoda's
Han
theme
Solo and
rules.
the Princess.
Oh,
I
yes.
mean,
One of the
dude,
greatest love themes ever, man.
It might be the best. I don't know, man. It's so tough to say. And I just think that that's the thing. Like the greatest moments of this are far more memorable than Jaws, in my opinion, because there's just so many great moments. And especially the stuff with, you know, like Yoda and the Force when he's lifting the X-wing out of the swamp. I mean, I could go on and on, Cloud City. I mean, there's so many, the asteroid chase. I'm just going on and on a
Asteroid
ramble right
Chase
now.
rules.
Oh
Oh my God.
man.
There's not a
And
weak
that
moment on the whole
finale.
thing.
Yeah, dude. And it's just like it leads to such stunning results. It's one of the most emotional scores that John Williams ever done all the way through. It's one of his darkest. It's The Empire Strikes Back, baby. What else can I say?
Exactly, man. And I mean, I couldn't have said it better myself. And Star Wars was amazing enough, but then to take it to the next level, like you often forget that the Imperial March wasn't even in the original Star Wars, like that came later. But man, just that's probably the most, other than the main Star Wars theme, of course, the most iconic from that whole series. I mean, just incredible. And all the other themes you mentioned. Yeah,
He should have won the
it's,
Oscar for this too, let's be
oh,
honest.
yeah, totally, man. I mean, come on. There's nothing score-wise. I mean, I'm sure there was some other stuff in 1980. Well, the Blues
But
Brothers, but
fame?
that
I don't
doesn't
know.
count as
I
a
haven't seen
score.
Fame yet, but like I can, and I'm sure that score is great, but Better than
Yeah.
Empire Strikes Back? I don't think so.
No way. Oh my God. That's what one that's crazy. But
Yeah.
yeah, I have that higher as well. So
Oh.
my number four was your five, which was Jaws. So now I guess we can go to your number three.
Oh, okay. If we're just going to, I we might as well.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I've got to readjust for a second. So
Yeah.
my number three has to be Raiders of the Lost Ark. Now, yet again, this could go back because I really struggled, John. I was like, which one do I put
Yeah.
above? But I felt
Right.
like I had to have Indiana Jones above Star Wars in some sense, right? So I
Yeah.
settled at having this at number three. And my goodness, I mean, just from the opening credit when they're going through the jungle and you know the Ark of the Covenant theme. I mean, of course, the Raiders March. I mean, this was a very original score if there ever was one. Yet
Yeah.
again, don't know how this lost evangelist for Chariots of Fire. Like, what the hell? That's
Yeah.
insane. That's like
Nuts.
literally like one motif, like one theme. Yeah, whoop-de-doo. Anyway,
Right.
this has Raiders March. And
Yeah.
then, you know, Marion's love theme. You talk about the
Another
best
great
love
one.
themes of all time. Oh my goodness, just
And the map room theme, dude.
the. Oh yeah, dude.
Amazing.
I
Yeah.
mean, you could go on and on. And dude, Desert Chase is probably one of the greatest
Yeah.
pieces of music John Williams ever composed. And I always
Yeah.
think of that scene where he's riding on the horse and then the Raiders theme goes and dun dun
Dun,
dun
dun,
dun and
dun.
oh
Yeah.
dun, 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 dun,
Yeah. Yeah.
dun, dun. I mean, you
Just
could go on.
amazing.
Oh man, it's just absolutely incredible. And this really set the standard for the rest of the Indiana Jones series, just the way he brings, like you're saying with Jaws, the adventure out of this music, out through the notes that are coming from all these players, man. It is just the definition of iconic, and it just kind of blows my mind. I mean, you talk about yet again the Superman theme. I put Raiders right up there as one of the greatest themes of all time. And sometimes I even wonder if it is the best, like beat for beat theme that John Williams has ever composed. I don't
Yeah.
know, but I think it might be.
Yeah. I can't disagree with you, man. And it's another one that I have higher on my list, as a matter of
I
fact.
figured as
So,
much.
and I did the same thing, like kind of wavering a little bit, because obviously I love The Last Crusade as well, and that has some additional cool themes. But like when I came back to it, I was just like, no, dude, Marion's theme, the map room, like all, yeah, the jungle chase, like all of it, they all have like these different feels to them. And yeah, nothing beats the Indiana Jones theme, man. Dun, 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 dun.
Incredible.
I mean, and to come, I mean, honestly, when you think about just albums in general, as far as like an album stretch to go from Empire to Raiders, to I think E.T. like
Yeah.
year after year. It's
Then Temple of Doom. I
insane.
mean,
Yeah.
it's
I mean,
nuts.
back to back, man, it's nuts. So that brings us into my number three, which I know for sure you have higher on your list. E.T. the Extraterrestrial. And man, this thing, this was hard to put as low as I did because,
Yeah.
as far as themes go, like honestly speaking, there's not one better. The flying theme. I
Oh.
mean,
Oh, yeah.
it's one of those, man. Like, and I'm not the biggest fan, as you know, of the film. Like, I love it, but it's not like one of my absolute favorites. It's not like in my top 100 or anything. But every time the flying theme, whichever scene it's in, comes in, I bawl like a little baby, man. Like, and it has to do probably with the fact that this was technically the first film I ever saw in a theater. So it's just like encapsulates my childhood in many ways. But there's just like, no matter who you are, man, I think that theme just that it does something to you. Like, he humanizes an alien in this film.
Yeah.
Like, what Spielberg and Williams accomplish with that is incredible. And yeah, just the whole from the bike chase all through the end, there's not like more perfect scoring, I think, for a film. So
No,
yeah.
I totally agree. And that's why I'll say, you know, before I get to my number two, I want to say I do think it is a little low, a little criminally low,
Yeah.
because
Yeah.
in my view, I think not only are these John Williams' two best scores, but I think these are the two greatest film scores of all time. Like
Yeah.
I like right above Lawrence of Arabia, right? So that's saying a lot. And my number two is E.T., the extraterrestrial. I mean, just for all the reasons you said and more, I think it is easily his most emotional score ever, and it won him, I think, his third Oscar for best original score, his fourth Oscar overall. I mean, this guy's insane. But this is just the perfect synergy of what Steven Spielberg brought to the screen, and John, like, and
Yep.
just watching the interviews of them talk about it, it's like magic in a bottle, even though it's not, because they've done this so many times. But I don't think they ever came close to what they accomplished here. And like you said, I mean, Adventure on Earth is the greatest
Yeah.
piece of music John Williams has ever composed, right up until that spaceship flies away, man. Just the powerful,
Da,
the
da,
da, like
da.
just the
Yeah.
horns. It's just so euphoric. Like, I'm getting emotional just thinking about how good it is. I
Yeah.
really do think that this is, like, beat for beat, one of the greatest film scores, like, as I said, top two ever. And I'm glad that he was honored for this one as well, because how can you not? This is an all-timer.
Yeah. Perfectly said, man. Yeah, this is really cool. So, it's just going to be like restructuring the order of these, but so my number two was Empire Strikes Back. So, yeah,
Oh,
just
didn't even put
because,
Star Wars on there.
yeah,
What?
man. I mean, dude, I Empire, like, there's not much more I can say than you already said, but like the reason I put it above ET, the highs in ET are undoubtedly the higher highs, but for me, like, for the entire soundtrack, just non-skip wise, Empire does it for me. So that's why I had it at two. So what, wait, what is your number one?
Star Wars, man.
Ah,
That's
of
like the
course.
most iconic film score. How is that? I know you said that, not Star Wars twice, but how is that not on the list, man? That's like
That's why I was like, I'm only gonna go with one series, like, per, or one, per thing. And yeah, like, it was almost impossible to leave Star Wars off, but because I put Empire and I put it so high, I left off Star Wars, man.
Oh, dude, big mistake, my friend, big mistake. Because
Yeah.
let me say something. This is the greatest film score of all time. I think most people would agree. I think it is number one on AFI's top film scores, isn't it? I
It might
believe so.
be. It probably
But
is.
yeah, probably. But here's
Yeah.
the thing, and of course won him his second Oscar for original score, his third Oscar. The thing that's so amazing about this literally changed everything. This is one of those scores that made this movie. Because this
Yeah.
movie, it would have been fun, but without John Williams' score, which is just so riveting, throwing back to the Eric Gornwald scores. I've just screwed his name up, but you know who I'm talking about. Of course, with the Adventure Robin Hood, Captain Blood, he somehow made this so much better in
Yeah.
a way that only John Williams could make it. And I think that, to me, is not only it's quite an achievement within itself, but you could go on about the many themes, the binary sunset, just the
Yeah,
main Star
yeah.
Wars theme alone is so iconic. Like, come on,
Yeah.
everybody knows that. And of course, I mean, dude, the trench run on the Death Star,
Yeah.
like
Yeah.
there's the Cantina theme. Like, I could go on and on as
Yep.
to how many great and iconic cues are in this movie. Just the way the orchestration's put together, nothing was done like this. And I don't think, yeah, he's come close to it, of course, it's John Williams, but I don't think that anything ever quite matches what he did. Now, as a saying about when it comes to the actual album, this isn't my favorite album from John Williams's career, and I think maybe it's the structure of it, because otherwise, I mean, this is, like, as I said, the greatest film score of all time, and I think it's certainly the most influential and iconic.
Okay, well, that's hard to argue, man. And quite honestly, like, I know we'll get to probably more honorable mentions here in a minute, but I also struggled to leave off Return of the Jedi, man, because like
Yeah, great one.
as a beat for beat, like, I mean, there's so many great moments in that are so enthralling, like the sail barge thing. That whole thing is great. Like, I remember even because my dad's a bit of a dork, but he would have that on cassette tape and we'd listen to that in the car, and
Oh,
he'd be
that's
like,
awesome, man.
he'd like speed up at like certain moments and stuff, and it was great. My childhood ruled. But also the Yub Nub theme, like the
Well,
Ewoks
not in the
too.
original movie, not in the
Yeah,
original movie,
right.
but
But exactly. But
well,
yeah,
actually,
dude.
wait, no, I'm an idiot. I'm thinking
No,
of the
it's
thing that you
the
put in later.
reverse. Yeah.
You're
Yub
right.
Nub
Yeah,
is the
you're right. My
original.
apologies. And
Yes.
it should have stayed that way, so I wouldn't be
Exactly.
talking out of my ass,
Yeah,
you
that's
know.
right. Dude, when we go back and watch this, I just love the way when I said, "What's your number one?" You're like, "Star Wars, man." Like,
Like, why would it be anything else, dude? Come
yeah. It's so
on.
great. So my number one, obviously, by process of elimination, is Raiders of the Lost Ark. The t-shirt, perfect. Which, dude, I had a Star Wars t-shirt, but I grew out of it. It shrunk on me, so I
Should have
just
just
got my,
forced it on,
this is
literally.
my Superman shirt right here.
I
So
guess so, yeah.
yeah.
I could have worn a Superman shirt, you know.
Yeah, you
It doesn't
know,
matter. I
but
got any. It's fine. It's fine.
so yeah, putting this together, man, this is now gonna take some math, because
Oh.
so my one and your three is higher than your two and my three. So technically, Raiders wins here as one.
Oh. Okay.
And then
Great.
E.T. at two.
Yeah.
And then we got to go with
John
Star Wars, because that
Empire.
was your
Empire.
one. Oh, yeah. If we want
Oh,
to go
wait.
based on. Well, hold on. If we do it based on points, let's see. Star Wars would get 5 points for you, Empire would get two for you, and four for me. So actually, Empire
That's what I
at
thought.
three.
Yeah.
Okay. Nice. Keeping me honest here.
This is
Okay.
criminal, man. I'm sorry. This is absolutely atrocious that
Empire and then Star Wars, and
it's
then Jaws makes it
low.
at
Okay.
five.
No,
Okay.
that's perfectly placed, I would say.
That is actually pretty great. I mean, I know you'd argue until both suns go down for Star Wars, but I which I get it, but yeah, that's great, man. So the official top five. How can you argue that, man? That's freaking, and that's just
Well,
a top
yeah.
five, because this man has done so many scores. Like, I'm just gonna name a couple honorable mentions for me that maybe you won't mention, I don't know, but Home
We'll
Alone,
see. Oh, yeah, great, great score.
amazing score, and like what he did with some of the Christmas classics, like just elevating them. But the theme song to that is beautiful. JFK is to
That's a good
me
one.
a riveting theme that like nobody ever talks about, but I think it's one that like it really just fits the film perfectly. And if we're going by that rationale, like what score of his doesn't fit perfectly a movie, really? And then, but the icing on the cake is just so many of these other ones. But I know you've probably got some other mentions that you want to get in there too.
Not many. I mean, because that's the thing. He has so many great. I mean, this dude has like 54 Academy Award nominations. Like, he's the most nominated living individual.
Yeah.
92 years, still going strong. I'm so happy for him.
Thank God. Yeah.
I would say that Superman was one, obviously, I mentioned earlier. I only had one other one that I think was legitimately a contender for this list, and that was Indiana Jones and the Last Crusade, which I think has, you know, some really, really strong themes
Yeah.
overall. I think the album is probably stronger than the Raiders of the Lost Ark one, but you know, you got to go with Raiders, and I just felt like
Yeah.
those other scores that I had to include above it that I think are more iconic. So,
Yeah.
but that's the thing. I could go on and on about,
I'm
how, I
surprised you
mean, the
didn't
Harry Potter
have
theme,
Jurassic Park, because I know you love that one too.
it's a bit repetitive. It's
Yeah,
not
I
his be
agree.
like the best themes are amazing. But not his absolute best. I will also have to give a shout out to, now this is not his original score by any means, but his first Academy Award win for Fiddler on the Roof. Great movie and great score as well. And then,
Yeah.
of course, you have to shout out, I'm sure that this wouldn't ever make any of the lists, but Schindler's List, which he won
Oh
his
yeah.
last
Yeah.
Oscar for.
Sure.
So, definitely have to shout those out. You could go on and on, though. I mean, this
Close
dude made some of the
Encounters
most
comes to
Close
mind
Encounters.
too. Just
Yeah,
a
that's up there.
dun-dun-dun-dun. Yeah.
And yet again, what
Yeah.
he can pull out of like five notes is insane. And the fact that that in
Yeah.
Star was the same exact year, and
Yeah.
he lost the Oscar for one of the greatest scores of all time to himself. Like,
Yeah.
that is a goat, man. Like,
Yes.
how
Yes,
can you
man.
beat that? And so I think, and also the Harry Potter theme is so iconic. Like,
Yep.
you could name so many that you'd be like, yeah, that was John Williams. It's just like, so we're so entrenched in the lexicon of pop culture, this music. I mean, I don't think that there's any other film composer that even comes close. You got Bernard Herrmann, you got Hans Zimmer, but I
Yeah.
really don't I can't think of anyone else, and even they're not on that level of
Dude.
just prolificness,
Yeah, like, and films aside, I'd put him up there as just one of the best composers of
Yeah,
all time.
I
Like,
agree.
why not? Yeah,
Yeah,
I
man.
mean, listen to
How
Return of the
can you not love
Jedi in the
Johnny
car,
Williams,
Exactly. Yeah,
Temple
man.
of Doom. I mean, we could go on and on. It would take us all day to get through all the great scores, but yeah, he's the greatest film composer of all time and one of the greatest musicians
Yeah.
that we have.
Well, yeah, you said it best, man. And that's why I had to give this episode a special, oomph and length to it, because to just go, less than 10 minutes on the great Johnny Williams, that
He
seems like a
deserves it, man.
disservice. Yeah, absolutely. One of the best of the best. And as is my counterpart here, one of the best of the best, Nathaniel Ahart, thank you for being on the show, man. Please, if you haven't checked out his channel, do yourself a favor. I mean, he's got rapid fire film reviews coming out, just one after another, and then some really great movies too this year. So, if you're behind like me on film, please check it out. But yeah, what else? Anything else coming on the pipeline for your channel these days?
Well, I'm trying to get a video done in a couple weeks. I don't want to say for sure because I don't want to, I still haven't done, speaking of John Williams, I don't think I'm ever finishing that Crystal Skull review. I'm sorry. But there
Yeah.
is one big video that I do want to try to get done before Wicked comes out. That's all I'll say.
All right. Well, guys, thank you so much for watching. As always, be sure to like, subscribe, all that jazz, and be sure, something else big coming up this next week. If you're in America, make sure that you remember to vote. So, yes, keep the democracy going, and we will see you soon. Love you, dude.
Love you too, man. Thanks for having me on.
All right, bro. Peace.